Today we're going to make a backing to say something, this recording. What we're going to do is we're going to find the tempo of the song, put it to logic, and then sequence all the parts together to make our own backing track. So to do this, we're going to open up logic. Create audio track. Command tab, command N, then go to desktop, go and grab say something HQ file, drag it across here. Next thing we're going to do is click on view, configure global tracks. We're going to select beat mapping, click done. Next thing I'm going to do is open this window, and then wherever I move my mouse, it'll change to a resizing icon or finger point icon. What I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight this and click detect. Once I've done that, it'll show up suggested beat mark points on this file. So I'm going to play the song, find out when first piano beat comes out down on beat one. So what we can hear, this is the beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. And what we need to do is I'm going to zoom this in. We need to align this to this coordinate here. This one to this beat. And the way we do this is I'm going to drag this locator. I'll highlight this. So that's beat one. So I'm going to listen to this again. Spacebar. 1, 2. So next one is going to be this one here. So that's beat two. I'll highlight this. Drag to there. Then I'm going to zoom in again. So it's going 1, 2, 3, 4, 3. What we're going to do is we're going to click on transients to get more suggested beat marks. So we can hear this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we need to do is we need to have this selected. So this is going to follow these coordinates up here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Sorry, wrong one. I meant 1, 2, 3, 4 up above. So this one here needs to be here. Three, four, and then I'll keep aligning this. Next thing I do is I'm going to put a metronome mode to check it so it's playing in time. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. I keep on doing this. Out the pluses and finding the beats to match this up. So you notice some of it's drifting when I zoom in. I'll highlight this. I'm going to do this for the whole song right to the end. So I'm going to do this really quickly so you get an idea of what you need to do. This should take one whole period for you to do to get it correct, to have it correctly done. So I'll quickly do this for you and show you what it should sound like. This is what you need to do for this exercise. So I've done a few bars. This is what it should sound like. So I've done up to bar 6, but you need to do this for the whole song, which is goes up to bar 45. So I'm going to play it from bar 1. So you can hear the metronome coming in and playing it correctly. And you need to have this done really, really accurately to make the backing track sound exactly like the original.
Say something, I'm giving up on you.
So what I'm gonna do is I'll zoom in. For example, we can see this one's playing a bit early. So what you need to do is you highlight this, drag it, so it lands exactly on that beat. when you're doing it, you will always have to rewind back a few bars to hear it, to make sure it's in time.
I'll be the one if.
And also, this one, you could hear it. This bar here was played a bit late. And the way this was recorded, that this wasn't recorded with a click track.
So, I'll be the one if you want me to.
You'll hear the next one.
I'll be the one if you want me to.
It's a bit late.
To.
So I'm going to quickly do this whole song, and this is what it should sound like. So once it's done, it should sound like this the whole way through.
I'm still learning to love. Just
once we've done that, we're going to do the instrumentation, and I'll give you the chords and charts for you to play this all in. The rest of the other stuff you will need to work out by ear by having a quick listen. And what we'll be doing is going through an instrumentation of this whole song. That's it for part one.